let us throw far off your baby son, Moses.
Into trouble for this?
No, not a chance.
Why did the gods torment me with such reckless, destructive, blasphemous sons?
Father, hear what I say.
Be still. Pharaoh speaks. I seek to build an empire, and your only thought is to amuse yourself by tearing it down. Have I taught you nothing?
You must not be so hard for yourself, your majesty. You're an excellent teacher.
It is not your fault that your sons learned nothing.
Well, they did learn blasphemy.
True.
Father, the fault is mine.
I goaded Ramses on, so I am responsible.
Responsible? And do you know the meaning of that word, Ramses?
I understand, father.
And do you understand the task for which your birth has destined you? The ancient tradition, when I pass into the next world, then you will be the morning and the evening star.
But one damaged temple does not destroy centuries of tradition.
But one weak link can break the chain of mighty dynasty. You have my leave to go.
But father. Father, you know it was really my fault. Must you be so hard on him?
Moses, you will never have to carry burden like a crown held past Ramses. He must not allow himself to be led astray. Not even by you, my son.
But all he cares about is your approval. I know he will live up to your expectations. He only needs the opportunity.
Maybe. Maybe so. Go now. I shall see you both tonight.
Well, that went well.
Just go away.
It could have been worse.
The weak link, that's what he called me.
Well, you are rather pathetic.
Irresponsible, ignorant of the traditions. He practically accused me of bringing down the whole dynasty.
Oh, I can see it now. There go the pyramids.
You can laugh about it.
Statues cracking and toppling over. The Nile drying up. Single-handedly, you'll manage to bring the greatest kingdom on earth to ruin.
Tell me this, Moses. Tell me, why is it that every time you start something, I'm the one who ends up in trouble?
Hey, I figured it out. You know what your problem is, Ramses?
What?
You care too much.
And your problem is that you don't care at all.
Well, in that case, I suppose that you care a lot more than I do that we're late for the banquet, for example.
I'm done for. Father will kill me.
Don't worry. Nobody will even notice.
Nobody will even notice.
Ah, young princess, Ramses, you are just named Prince Regent. You are now responsible for overseeing all the temples. Now, I suggest you get over there and thank your father. Apparently, Moses, someone thought he just needed the opportunity.
My lord Pharaoh, I propose that the high priest offer a tribute to their new regent.
An excellent idea. Hotep, hoi.
Hoi.
The Median girl, go get her.
By the power of Ra, we present for your delectation and delight an exotic apparition stolen from faraway lands. We offer you this delicate desert flower.
Let us inspect this desert flower. More like a desert cobra. Not much of a snake charmer, are you? Well, that's why I give her to you.
No, that's quite generous, but I won't be given to anyone, especially an arrogant, pampered palace brat.
Will you let her talk to you like that?
You will show the proper respect for a princess of Egypt, but I'm showing you all the respect you deserve. None!
Be still!
I demand you to set me free!
Be still!
Let me go!
And you wish.
You there! Have her sent to Prince Moses' chamber. If it pleases you, Father, my first act as regent is to appoint Moses as royal chief architect.
Guards!
Prince Moses.
Yes, sir.
There's a man tied up in my room. Well, look into it.
Right away, sir.
Please, I need water. I have a long journey ahead of me.
May God protect you.
Thank you.
Expect to see you here. Of all places, our door. At last.
At last?
Didn't I tell you? I knew he would return to us when he was ready.
Miriam, do you want us flogged?
I knew you care about our freedom.
Freedom? Why would I care about that?
Because you're our brother.
What?
They never told you?
Who never told me what?
But you're here, you must know.
Be careful, slave.
Oh my good prince, She's exhausted from the day's work. Not that it was too much. We quite enjoyed it, but she's confused and knows not to whom she speaks.
I know to whom I speak, Ern. I know who you are, and you are not a prince of Egypt.
What did you say?
Your Highness, pay her no heed. Come, Miriam. May I discuss something with you?
No, Ern. Please, Moses, you must believe. You're born on my mother, you
have. That's enough!
You're a brother!
Stop it!
Now you go too far. You shall be punished.
No, please, Your Highness. She's ill. She's very ill. We beg your forgiveness. Please, Miriam, let us go.
No, Ern. Our mother set you adrift in the basket to save your life.
Save my life? From who?
Ask the man who you call father.
How dare you?
God save you to be our deliverer.
Enough of this.
And you are, Moses. You are a deliverer.
I said, enough. You will regret this night.
Hush now, my baby, misty love, don't cry. Sleep as your
clean and all I ever known, all I ever wanted. Sweet perfumes of incense, graceful rooms of alabaster stone, all I ever wanted. This is my home, with my father, mother, brother, oh so noble, oh so strong. Now I am home, here among my trappings and belongings I belong. And if anybody doubts it, they couldn't be more wrong. The proud history that's shown, etched on every wall. Surely this is all I ever wanted, all I ever wanted, all I ever wanted.
Against us.
Father, please, tell me you didn't do this.
Sometimes for the greater good, sacrifices must be made.
Sacrifices?
Oh, my son, they were only slaves.
Thank you.
Moses?
Is this where you found me?
Moses, please try to understand.
So, everything I thought, and everything I am, is a lie.
No, you are our son, and we love you.
Why did you choose me?
We didn't, Moses. The gods did.
This is your home, my son. Here the river brought you, and it's here the river meant to be your home. Now you know the truth, love. Now forget and be content. When the gods send you a blessing, you don't ask why it was sent.
I'll make it more grand, more splendid than anything else in Upper and Lower Egypt. Moses, look, fate has turned our little misadventure into a great opportunity. You know, Father will be so pleased.
Get up, old man! Put your back into it! Faster!
This is just the beginning. A gateway will open into an entire new city of white limestone more dazzling than the sun. And here, a statue of Hapi, the god of the Nile.
Faster! Hurry!
Two great column halls.
Stop it! Someone's got to stop this!
There's nothing we can do.
Stop it! Stop it! Leave that man alone!
Out of my way! Who did this?
Over there, it's him!
Moses!
Moses, what's going on? Moses, wait!
Let me go!
What's going on?
You saw what happened? I just killed a man.
We can take care of that. I'll make it so it never happened.
Nothing you can say will change what I've done.
But I am the morning and the evening star. If I say day is night, it will be written. And I say you are innocent.
What you say does not matter. I can't stay here any longer.
But why?
All I ever known to be true is a lie. I'm not who you think I am.
What are you talking about?
Go ask the man I once called father.
Moses.
Goodbye, brother.
ship's drink.
Our father's the high priest of Midian. You're going to be in big trouble.
Hot hearts.
Oh, let me through, let me through. I want to see him. You're most welcome. You shall not be a stranger in this land. You have been sent as a blessing. And tonight, you shall be my honored guest.
My father, Jethro, High Priest of Midian, come with me.
Sit with me.
All right.
My children, let us give thanks for this bountiful food, and let us also give thanks for a present of a brave young man whom we honor here tonight.
Please, sir, I wish you wouldn't. I have done nothing in my life worth honoring.
First, you risk it, Sephora. Then you defend my younger daughters from brigands. You think that is nothing? It seems you don't know what is worthy of honoring. A single thread in a tapestry, though its color brightly shine, can never see its purpose in the pattern of the ground design. And the stone that sits on the very top of the mountain's mighty face, does it think it's more important than a stone that forms the base? So how do you know what your life is worth, or where your value lies? You can never see with your eyes of men. You must look at your life, look at your life through heaven's eyes. La 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 la.
I don't know how.
La 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 desert sun is less than cold for spring, and to one lost sheep a shepherd boy is greater than the richest king. If a man whose earthly thing he owns has eternally lost his worth, or is it the beginning of a new and brighter birth? So how do you know the measure of man, if less or strength or science, how much he gained or how much he gave? The answer will come. The answer will come to him who tries to look at his life through heaven's eyes. And that's why we shall be here with you, though this little to be found. When all you've got is nothing, there's a lot to go around. Oh, life can escape being blown about by the winds of change and chance. And though you never know all the steps, you must learn to join the dance. You must learn to join the
Take the sandals from your feet. The place in which you stand is holy ground.
Who are you?
I am that
What do you want with me?
I have seen the oppression of my people in Egypt, and I have heard their cries. So I have come down to deliver them out of slavery and bring them to a good land. A land flowing with milk and honey. And so unto Pharaoh, I shall send you.
Me? Who I am to lead these people? They'll never understand. They won't even listen.
I shall teach you what to say.
But I was their enemy. I was the prince of Egypt, son of the man who slaughtered their children. You've chosen the wrong messenger. How can I even speak to these people?
Who made man's mouth? Who made the deaf, the mute, the seeing, or the blind? Did not I? Now go. Oh, Moses, I shall be with you when you go to the king of Egypt. But Pharaoh will not listen. So I will stretch out my hand and smite Egypt with all my wonders. Take the staff in your hand. With it, you shall do my wonders. I shall be with you, Moses. Moses. Moses.
Moses, you are just one man. Zipporah, please, look at your family. They are free. They have a future. They have hopes and dreams and a promise of a life with dignity. That is what I want for my people. And that's why I must do the tasks that God has given me.
I'm coming with you.
Thank you.
Ramses?
Moses? Moses! I thought you were dead.
Look at you! Pharaoh!
Well, look at you! What on earth are you dressed as?
It's so good to see you, Ramses.
Excuse me, Your Majesty. We are compelled to remind you that this man committed a serious crime against the gods.
We love to bring it up, mind you.
Yet, the law clearly states a punishment for such a crime is
death.
We hesitate to say.
Be still. Pharaoh speaks.
Ramses.
I am the morning and the evening star. It shall be as I say. I pardon forever all crimes this man stands accused of, and will have him know as Moses, the Prince of Egypt.
Ramses, in my heart, you are my brother, but things cannot be as they were.
I see no reason why not.
You know, I am a Hebrew, and the God of the Hebrews came to me. He commands that you let his people go.
Commands? Hotep Hoi, show my brother our answer.
Big boys now!
All right, Moses. I know you. What is this really about?
Look, Ramses. What do you see?
A greater Egypt than that of my father.
That is not what I see.
Moses, I cannot change what you see. I have to maintain the ancient traditions. I bear the weight of my father's crown.
Do you still not understand what Seti was?
A great leader.
His hands bore the blood of thousands of children.
Slaves.
My people. And they cannot longer hide in the desert while they suffer. At your hands.
So, you have returned, only to free them? I had hoped. But I do not know this god, and neither will I let your people go.
Ramses, please.
I will not be the weak link. Tell your people, as of today, their workload has been doubled. Thanks to your god, or is it thanks to you?
Struck to the ground.
I didn't mean to cause you more pain. I was just trying to do as God told me.
God? When did the God start caring about any of us? In fact, Moses, when did you start caring about slaves? Was it when you found out that you were one of us?
Don't listen to him.
No. He's right. I did not see. Because I did not wish to see.
You didn't see because you didn't wish to see. Oh, well, that makes everything fine then, doesn't it?
Aaron, you shame yourself.
I'm so sorry, Marianne.
Moses, hear what I say. I've been a slave all my life. And God had never answered my prayers until now. God saved you from the river. He saved you in all your wandering. Even now, he saved you from rough Pharaoh. God will never abandon you. So don't you abandon us.
Let my people go.
Still gnawing at the bone, are we?
You cannot keep ignoring us.
I've heard enough of this Hebrew nonsense. Bring him to me. Moses!
No!
Take the staff in your hand, Moses.
Futile mission, Moses. I've indulged you long enough. This must now be finished.
No, Ramses. This is only the beginning.
But, Moses, didn't you see what happened? The priest did the same thing. Pharaoh still has the power over our lives.
Yes, Aaron. It's true. Pharaoh has the power. He can take away your food, your home, your freedom. He can take away your sons and daughters. With one word, he can take your very lives. But there is one thing that Pharaoh cannot take away from you. Your faith. Believe, for we will see God's wonders. Once I thought the chance to make you laugh was all I ever wanted. And even now I wish that God has chosen another. Serving as your foe on his behalf is the last thing that I wanted. This was my home. All this pain and devastation, how it tortures me inside. All the innocent who suffered from your stubbornness and pride. Why, cold brother, why must you call down another blow? You have come to hate me so.
Marte.
Ramesses?
Let me guess. You want me to let your people go?
I thought I would find you here.
Get out!
Ramesses, we must bring this to an end. Talk to me. We could always talk here. This place, so many memories. I remember the time you switched the heads of the gods of the Temple of Ra.
If I recall correctly, you were there switching heads right along with me.
No, I didn't do that.
Oh yes, you did. You switched the hippo on the crocodile and the crocodile on
the falcon.
Yes! The priest thought it was a bad omen and fasted for 2 months. Father was furious. You are always getting me into trouble. But then again, you are always getting me out of trouble again. Why can't things be the way they were before?
It's so dark. I'm frightened. Why is he here? Isn't that the man with all this?
Yes. And one must wonder why.
Because no kingdom should be made on backs of slaves. Ramesses, your stubbornness is bringing this misery upon Egypt. It would cease only if you would let the Hebrews go.
I will not be threatened. I will not be dictated to. I am the morning and the evening star. I'm Pharaoh.
Something else is coming. Something much worse than anything before. Ramesses, please let go of your contempt for life before it threatens everything you hold dear. Think of your son.
I do. You Hebrews have been nothing but trouble. My father had the right idea of how to deal with you people. And I think I should finish the job.
Ramesses, no.
And there shall be a great cry in all of Egypt, such as never has been or ever will be again.
Ramesses, you're praying this upon yourself.
Thank you.
God came to me again, saying, take a lamb, and with its blood, mark the lintel and the posts of every door. For tonight, I shall pass through the land of Egypt and smite with all the firstborn. But when I see the blood upon your door, I shall pass over you, and the plague shall not enter.
And your people have my permission to go. Leave me!
Thank you.
With this staff, you shall do my wonders.
Egyptians, they're coming!
Your people, Moses. They are free.
Thank you.
pierwszy zespół taneczny. W roli poganiaczy niewolników Max Kozerski, Max Kanak, Han Wiśniewska. Faraon Seti, Królowa Tuja, Gabi Górecka, Dominika Prokopowicz. Kapłani, Hotep i Choi, Marianka Kubas, Marysia Buczko. Nefertari oraz syn Ramzesa, Hania Karbowska, Szymek Nowak-Pirmendi. Madia Niccy Zbuje, Szymek Łaczmański i Ala Egert. Stare Madia Nitki, Maja Nowak-Kirmendi, Hania Karbowska. Siostry Sefory, Efora, Adżolidofora i Jetrodiada. Zuzia Kalinowska, Ola Skrzypek, Pola Janiec. W roli Jetry, Jeremi Zbudniewek. Głos Boga, Karl Dolens. Niewolnicy 1 i 2, Danusia Wiśniewska, Maja Nowak-Kirmendi. Małe hebrajskie dziecko, Zosia Namiotko. Dorosły Aaron i Jochewet, Ala Egert, Madzia Łaczmańska. Mali Aaron i Miriam, Lidzia i Basia Łaczmańskie. Miriam i Sefora, Gabi Górecka, Natalia Eminowicz-Florczak. Mojżesz i Ramzes, Mania Laitalainen, Amelka Grajda. Inspicjenci garderobiany, Kosia Małek, Ola Bożyk, Janek Ostapiuk, Antek Wilk, Han Wiśniewska, Marysia Śmietana, to jest nasz backstage, którego nie widać, ale bez nich nie ma nic. Sekcja beauty, dziewczyny zapraszamy, sekcję beauty, Helena Wichar, Elena Chleb-Koszańska, Sandra Gozdek. Brawa dla asystenta reżysera, czyli Janka Konarskiego. Dziękujemy naszej ekipie technicznej za udźwiękowienie, oświetlenie, panu Marcinowi Ptakowi, Maćkowi, Piotrkowi z tyłu, tak, i Damianowi Białoruckiemu. Dziękujemy. Słuchajcie, nie będę już wyczytywać całej listy, ale bardzo dziękujemy wszystkim instruktorom, dziękujemy Ośrodkowi Kultury i Sportu w Zielonce za to, że mogliśmy tutaj gościć z tym spektaklem i dziękujemy też Wam, brawa dla widowni, za tak ciepłe przyjęcie z naszej strony. Dziękujemy.
I wielkie brawa dla pani Marty.
Moracz English Theatre.